What's your name?
Gage.
Gage. Which subject do you present on?
Pasha number.
Avaya. The conference is now starting. You are the first person to arrive. You will now be placed into the conference. The conference is now being recorded.
It's a very nice drawing you got on the board.
It's not mine.
Just claim it as your own. We're not going to know.
Huh?
We're not going to know. Okay, we know now.
Well, if it would be mine, you would see big discrepancy with this high artistic skills and stuff that I'm drawing. Yes. It tells that it is in the lobby by the stairs.
Check this looking at this.
I think so.
It's in the lobby, you say?
Yep.
Okay. not a question for me. Oh!
So how your schedules look like for Wednesday afternoon?
Do you have any?
How do your schedules look for Wednesday afternoon? Do you need to go to another lab or plan some generalist for the semester?
Analytical lab is today.
Yeah.
That's right.
When does
2 to 4:50?
Yeah.
2 to 4:50.
Yeah. So everyone in analyticals lab.
Okay. But nothing after.
No. Nope.
So starting from, there will be no one rushing to leave earlier. Mostly.
Unless it's for a job or something, but yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, same. Not today.
So we'll start slowly but surely. Previous semesters I was postponing this pleasant time until maybe like third week or fourth week, because right now we are in the class material, we are not in the position to solve any practical problems, but if we, like right now we are approaching to the merging point from two directions. In class, we accumulate some background, and here we can start slowly get some minimalistic computational background. So at the time when we need to solve problems, we would not bother ourselves with writing too much equations, but use computers to solve them. So the software that we are going to practice is so-called MATLAB. Did you ever practice it? So what you can do, just log in with your credentials and try to find it just in the...
What's it called?
MATLAB. See? If you just run it, you'll see window like the one here, and you can try just to explore it on your own. So there are it's very rich software with many functional abilities. We're not going. It's not course in scientific computing. We will need very, very minimal basic, but you can glance through and find such things which I'm not aware of. This software is used not only for scientific computing, but it is also used for processing data, and often it is used to for connection between real experimental instruments and analyzing the accumulated data. So if you are bored to listen to me, you can just try anything you can. For example, you can type demo, and then there will be help button, or there will be several opportunities to try, and you may find some fun stuff. So in addition to solving problems in a very efficient and quick way compared to standard programming tools, it is a very powerful visualization tool. So it just makes nice images, videos, and sounds, and you may find something that you would like. So today, our meeting is very informal. When we will meet probably next week, I will prepare a list of formal skills that you need for the course, and we will go through them one by one. So really minimal condensed stuff. And today I can just entertain you with maybe trying something without much organization, just for example,
Question.
Yes, go ahead.
Is this a specific type of coding, or is this based off of C++?
This is an interpreter.
Okay, so it uses its own language.
Right.
Okay.
There is a tool that converts MATLAB scripts into C++.
Okay.
So if you write something precious that you want to run on a high performance computer cluster to be more quicker and efficient, you can convert MATLAB script, compile, and then run it really, really quick.
Okay.
But we are in educational system. We are not like targeting super high performance.
Okay.
It's main goal is to have the easy that we write minimal amount of lines of code or no lines of code at all. So like 1 to 10 lines and that's it. Functions.
Oh, please give me some hint if you already, if you were dealing with some processing of experimental data or some sort of scientific computing. Some programming, if you know the name of the compiler.
I know a little bit. Okay, no. Just a little bit. I know how to make variables.
That's good. Can you? That's great. Can you plot functions? Plot sine x with any computational tool. Well, I know you all can do it with Excel, right?
For the most part.
Okay. Let's do spiral that I was trying to hand draw during the class. So when we deal with calculus and math, the variables are continuous. They can take any value. But if you do things in the memory of computer or on the screen, they're discretized, right? If all images, they are split on grid points, right? And if you want to represent a function, you just need to, if you have x axis, you need to split onto several grid points. If you want fine, high resolution TV, you need many dots per inch. If you don't care about resolution, you can have coarse grain. So, you can, of course, one can set up variables and values. And then if you type x, you have whatever you set it. And if you set, you can do some simple arithmetic. So you can use MATLAB as a calculator. Right, but it is boring. We will go through it in a more formal part, but you can set arrays. And then if you type X, it will understand that it is a set of data. But if you want to make graphs, we need right now we did assign to array X values from 1 to 7 and here they are. We can connect them by lines or we can just put them as dots. But if we want some functions, it is too rough. When I'm trying something, please try to do the same. I didn't ask most important question. Were you able to run MATLAB? Is it installed on the desktops where you're sitting? Good. So if I do want to set the value of variable, make it like vector or array of data, explicitly typing all values, it's a little boring. I'm not a robot, I cannot do 1,000 times. So I can, instead of telling 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, I can just for 127. And it will be the same, right? So putting column would putting a column would do the same job as mentioning things explicitly. But still, integers are not sufficient. We may want to have the specific step. So I can go from 1 to 10 with step 1, with integer step. But no one prevents me to make step more than 1, to do bigger step, or make it like 0.5. So then it goes by this fractional numbers, right? And if I have this variable with a little bit more denser steps, it is a better argument in mathematical sense. I can put it as argument into a function. But let's do this. I know it is a little childish and too simple, but there is no reason to just watch. So this is an image that's too pathetic to represent straight line. We need much denser dots. So why don't I type, instead of 0.5, 0.1. And now they are almost indistinguishable, they form a line. If we place two arguments in the plot command, we can put x square for quadratic function or whatever function you need, or sine x, then you will see the graph. it's interesting. The MATLAB has crazy syntaxes. If you would forget about period before the power, it will not do things for you. If you want like do polynomial like x squared, x cubed, or 1 over x, you need to do this period and then power. Please try.
So what is the period then? Period means to consider each array as a number rather than okay, because later on, very soon, you realize, recognize, and practice that there will be a lot of vectors and matrices, and MATLAB is not for math, it's for matrices. And when you multiply vectors and matrices, there are some rules that are and if you don't, this period means like avoid rules for matrices and process elements as usual numbers. Otherwise, if you do not put this period, it will process it as they would be vectors or whatever. So we can plot sine, cosine, exponential, and if you put plot 3, number 3 in here, you will be able to plot things in 3 dimensions. So it's basically the shape that we did in class. For the propagating wave. So please try to practice. Error.
Why does it have to be a
three? Because three dimensional. Typically, all these are two dimensional.
Okay.
Well, if you ever need plots that you generate with MATLAB for like some lab reports, if you would use it instead of your Excel for labs ever, this gray background may irritate you or whoever will read your products. So there is a way, see there is a little arrow here, edit plot, and then you can click and change figure color to white background, which is sort of more visually presentable. And just try to click on different things, you can make bigger fonts, thicker lines, and that stuff to make it more readable for outside users. I didn't have a specific plan for today, but you give an inspiring question. So you can type, hold on to keep the image, and then plot maybe same stuff, but with double frequency, and maybe make different color. Make sense?
Yeah, I know there was a hold on, but
try to check if you have the console of the chain to grow phones.
Yeah, I got the other one.
That's not a shame.
Thank you.
Did you create this, this
color?
Yes.
Why is it so thick?
Just threw it all there.
What equation is that over there? Tangent and cotangent?
What are you trying to
use?
Steam for more things.
We have Kevin Fine. He's working here. How do you multiply vectors?
You're talking dot or cross product.
Huh?
Are you talking dot or cross product?
As there any other products? So the cross product is defined for three-dimensional vectors.
Yeah.
So it's very specific. But there is a dot product is very universal. Scalar product because it gives for the multi-dimensional vectors, is just one number. And there is a so-called
dyadic product. So, do you have steam? Not tired yet? Not, I don't, not, huh?
A little bit left for the
day. Okay. So, vectors. Let's, let me write maybe x equals, same as we did before, 1, 2. So, in some sense, we can call that x capital is a vector, right? But on the other hand, I can write y equals 3, 4. So what's the difference between x and y vectors?
One has two bounds, one has two bounds.
Yeah, but it's they both are one-dimensional vectors, right? So one has structure of like is row vector and another is column vector, right? So what will be the result of multiplication of this of these two vectors, x and y? X equals 1, 2, y equals 3, 4. How do you get it?
You multiply the column by the rows, but I can't remember exactly which one goes where.
So you're telling me that 1 times 3 plus 2 times 4?
Yeah.
Let's try. Prove it with MATLAB.
Okay, 1 second.
But you can save it at a specific
thing. Okay, that's fine.
You put a space in there? Oh yeah, because there was a thing on it.
Yeah, I'll leave it. And you know how to save files, right? To save data, because there should be something like virtual space, because these computers will not hold your information when they walk around. And if you generate something precious, you will save it or sell it and give it to the site.
So I don't know how to do it on there, because I'm in the code part. You're in the command window.
Anyone got anything different than
I didn't
get
my window.
So what is it? Which data structure did you build?
What's that?
Which structure of data? Like 11 is a single number. What did you?
I got 3, 6 and then 4, 8, so it's coming up as the.
So he was wrong.
I don't know. I
probably didn't. I got 11.
Now you need to fight.
You probably right. How do you multiply yours if you just do y times x?
Oh, if you do. Wait, let me try
something. Matrices, I don't know.
Are you doing z times q? I mean, x times y or y times x?
That's the question.
Oh, yeah.
Right? I did z times q, which will give you a scalar.
And if you do what was it?
It gives you a 2 by 2 matrix.
Yes. So the second one is called dyadic product.
I did my
times
x.
So
x times y.
Oh,
3, 6, 4, 8.
I said x.
Oh, they need to be the same.
This is the crap I'm just grabbing.
They should have the same dimension.
I wish you could come on here how much I can zoom on. It took a while to run through it.
Oh yeah, I did 0.001. I did 0.001.
I did 1 to the bank. It worked.
I'm proud of you.
It just looks like that. Yeah, it takes
a
little bit of process.
Small case, it's a can of bank property. I don't know that.
Okay. I'm gonna close out of this.
Yeah.
So your argument is for 11. My argument's for 11.
So what did you get? Oh, okay.
I did both. Command.
So it does matter. Now let's try to do both. Let me try to do both things without a computer. So if you have your x equals 1, 2, and y equals 3, 4, I'm doing scalar product, x times dot product, which will be 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the row by column rule, right? So 1 times 3. Plus 2 times 4, right? But if we swap the order, if you do y times x, it will be 3 times 4 times 1, 2, right? Now if you practice the rule row by column, here it was just one row and one column, therefore it will be one number. Here it will be one first row and first column. So it will be matrix. So 3 times 1. Then first row, second column. 3 times 2. Then second row, first column. 4 times 1. Second row, second column. 4 times 3. So it will be 3, 6, 4, 12. Does it go along with what you got?
No.
No?
You said 4 times 3 instead of 4 times 2.
Okay.
On the bottom,
right? Right. 2, 8. Better now?
Yep.
Okay. So it is same objects but in different order.
Right?
Yep. So it does matter whether it is. Whether your vector is row or column, right? So this is dot, and this is called diadic. So it is a way to generate matrix out of vectors. There is a way to convert. So x is row, but if you type x prime, it will become column. How do you call it in linear algebra? Transpose, right? If you type y, it is 3, 4. If you type y prime, what should we get?
3, 4.
Yes. Okay? Good. Let me check myself. Y times x, yes, 3, 6, 4, 8. Good. Well, if it is vectors of a small dimension, like 2, 3, it's fine to represent them by numbers. But if it is long vectors, we plot them as functions and you're already skewed. But how do you plot functions? Plot, visualize matrices. Because like if it is four numbers, it's fine to discuss in person. But if it will be matrix of 100 by 100, it's too much to give or watch numbers. So there is I want new figure, and I type bar 3 of whatever my matrix is. So those are 3, 4, 6, 8, right? Just a little, histogram, bars popping up. And if you happen to generate metrics of bigger dimension, it is not a problem, and you can visually analyze its properties. Let me walk through and see how you visualize matrices. What would be the next step to check or to try if you would have steam? Probably multiply matrices by vectors or matrices by each other, right? I don't know if you have steam, and if I have steam, I kind of given a heads up what is possible and what would be reasonable for the course. So if you have matrices, you can add them together, subtract, multiply. You can multiply matrices by vectors. But what else can you do with matrices? Find determinant, right? What else? Three things. Find determinant and two more. Probably, I'm not sure if we need to do more things today, but let me just give you the heads up. What one can do is matrices. So determinant, eigenvalues, and solving linear algebraic equations.
Systems.
Yes, system of linear algebraic equations. Like if you have a x b y equals c, a prime x b prime y equals d, then it is a this system of equation can be written as a matrix of a b A prime B prime matrix times X Y equals C D. Right? And these two are known, and the this vector is unknown. Right?
Yeah.
So if it is very few equations, you just write them by adding, subtracting in a natural way. But if there are large number, there is a general way. So if you call this one A capital, this one X capital, and this one, I don't know, C, your vector equation is matrix times vector C equals X C. Then it's another thing I hated in my freshman years when people start instructors started writing equations like this without explanation, and assuming that everyone is so happy and understanding this. Tell me if you want explanations. Yes?
You want explanations.
So, algebraically, formally, without any, if those are just symbols for us, if we have an object into minus first power, like if you multiply x minus 1 times x, it will be equal to
1.
So if you have some unknown symbol of unknown nature into power minus 1 times same symbol without this in power 1, it will be 1. So if this unknown symbol is matrix, then upon multiplication matrix into power minus 1 by doing matrix in without any power, you'll get just so-called unitary matrix, when you have ones on main diagonals, zeros
and... Identity matrix?
Yeah, identity matrix. And this to the power minus 1 is inverse of a matrix, right? Make sense?
Yeah.
So if you multiply A minus first to the A, it's same as if you have nothing. It means you have just your vector x. And in order to be mathematically correct, you need to perform this operation on both sides, left and right. A minus first, left and right. On the left it cancelled, on the right you have this A minus first multiplied by this free term. And x was an unknown in this algebraic system of equations, which means if you take this free term multiplied by inverse matrix, you immediately get solution of your system of equations, right?
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, it is determinant, inverse, and eigenvalues. So three things you may want to do with matrices. Determinant is just to check whether it is good or bad matrix. Inverse, because you need to solve linear system of equations sometimes. And eigenvalues, I don't care about other branches of science, but physical chemistry and quanta, you saw today on the lecture, there is a time-independent equation that is basically eigenvalue problem. I didn't plan to go so far. Should we? Okay, let's maybe start practicing some of those.
Type in Lorentz on your command bar.
Let me see you.
It's like a function that MATLAB apparently understands.
Oh, it's a strange attractor.
You can also ask it why, say random density. You can ask it why.
To satisfy the terrified kid.
Well, I'm very happy that you are so creative. It is what when I was doing it several years, just trying to tackle different things. And then it will help you to do things later, so you find some useful. Okay, let me do just a little numerical experiment with our matrix A. So we have A, and we can, let's check if we have... okay, this equation doesn't have solution. Okay, so I cheated and selected matrix that can be inverted. And now if I okay. So I do not have steam to go into a practical solution of some linear system of equations, but it is the little experiment. If we define a matrix, not arbitrary, well, arbitrary, but not every matrix can be inverted. And then we define the inverted matrix. Then if it does exist, then product of the inverted times original matrix is expected to give the identity. So, please practice.
Just to check.
Okay, I think now you start to want this course.
Oh, I found a bot.
Good.
Oh. Oh. Oh,
forgot. I installed my this and then the chain person Z.
Not every if the matrix has zero determinant, you could give this infinite. Divide by zero.
It's just like, but
yeah, I'm not sure if a to the power of minus one will work. It inverses more special stuff.
Damn it.
Oh. This Okay, well, you can stay here and play, but maybe it's enough of new material. You already had some fun, and you are way ahead of the planned schedule of the course. So let's play as long as you want. I will stay here and answer questions, but next week we'll go in a more organized way and have a set of skills that we will need for the rest of the course. I'll stay here maybe for 15, 20 minutes if you have questions related not only to MATLAB but to the presentations on Friday or to the course material. I would be happy to answer or contribute.
So what are you expecting from these presentations? Just give the class like just like a general outline?
I have a like multifold goal. First, I need to develop some assignments that you that you give me. Fundamental to give you guys good grades at the end.
Okay.
Design some assignments before. Well. Like if you solve problems, there is a chance for error. If you do presentations, it's like basically everyone gets it.
Yep.
Another thing, right now I do not remember the names of anyone.
Okay.
But after you guys present, I will names. The most deep, I don't know if you work out another. The things that I'm presenting in class may or may not be logically organized for your eyes.
Okay.
So, but if this posture is an attempt to summarize basics of quantum theory in a very short and organized way. And if you do present it yourself in a team style,
a better understand.
You'll summarize and organize the information in your heads.
Okay. That works.
Yeah. I cannot avoid solving problems. We will do some. I don't want to spoil your career and grades and want to balance different things so that even if problem solving will be like so, final grade will not be much damaged.
Okay. That works. Yeah. Perfect. Thank you.
All right. See you later.
See you.